The reception has actually been very warm. There is a lot of interest also, which is quite encouraging. The investors are paying, kind of attention to our economy and what is happening back home.
What sort of reception have you got from the ratings agencies, and do you think you've done enough to avoid a downgrade?
Look, it's not only about just avoiding a ratings downgrade. It's about doing good in the interest of the country and in the process. What then happens is that if we do good in terms of economic growth, in terms of dealing with our risks, and in terms of dealing with challenges pertaining to dealing with the bottlenecks in the economy, all of those things first and foremost address our own challenges of creating employment, of dealing with poverty alleviation, of dealing with issues of underdevelopment and inequalities. In the process then, as we are able to achieve that, that is what also the ratings agencies would do. But as you would recall that Moody's was in South Africa last week, they were the first people also that we met with when we came here, also to check the consistency of the messaging, but also the credibility of our story. Because as we are here, as a delegation that is made up of government, business, labor, It is clear that we all have, one purpose, and we are united in achieving that purpose.
And what message are you trying to send out with plans for the $3 billion bond sale?
International bond issuance is something that is always part of our artillery in terms of diversifying our fundraising or revenue raising mechanisms, but also it is taking advantage of the favorable global economic environment towards ourselves. But this is something that is done. It's just the $3 billion is just the number that was penciled in, but it depends on how the market responds and reacts to this thing. But at the end of the day, it is something that our team at Assets and Liabilities continuously work on and look at what the environment and the climate is at a particular given time and act appropriately.
Have you heard concerns about the land reform proposals, and have you been able to address those concerns?
Indeed, I think the latest development that this matter is now with the Constitutional Review Committee helps to bring about stability and certainty that it is where it belongs. As we know that this is a constitutional matter, and unless it is dealt with at that level of the Constitutional Review Committee, it lends itself to unnecessary abuse by people for opportunistic political reasons. And I think as a country, we are in a position to be able to say, because of our systems and institutions that are in place, we are better able to deal with some of the emotional and difficult questions in a manner that is responsible. And as you have heard in the President's own pronouncements, that this is going to be done in a responsible manner that ensures that we do not unnecessarily impact negatively on food security, on economic growth and development, but also continues to promote social cohesion.
That was the old and new finance minister, Nhlanhla Nene, speaking to our correspondent in London.